Hello everyone, myself, Dr. Deepali Vittal Trimukhe, working as a second year junior resident in Department of Radio Diagnosis at Mikhail Walawalkar Rural Medical College, Ratnagiri. So my topic for paper presentation is anatomical variations of paranasal sinuses and its association with sinusitis. Chronic sinusitis refers to ongoing long-term sinus infection inflammation. It is a common pathology encountered day-to-day. Paranasal sinuses variation are commonly seen in patients of chronic sinusitis and hence need further assessment. CT is an excellent modality for evaluation of anatomy, variants, and pathology related to paranasal sinuses, especially prior to FES, that is functional endoscopic sinus surgery. This study is a case series which correlates anatomical variation of paranasal sinuses and its association with chronic sinusitis. The aim of my study is to evaluate prevalence of anatomical variants of paranasal sinuses and its likely association with chronic sinusitis and to evaluate the variant that strongly contributes to chronic sinusitis. The type of study is retrospective. My study included 50 patients with symptoms of sinusitis who underwent CT in past 2 months in our department. Exclusion criteria included patients with sinonasal malignancy and history of accidental facial injuries. The anatomy of paranasal sinuses was evaluated in both bone and soft tissue window, and findings were further included in study. Following parameters were observed in the study. First is involved sinuses, that is frontal, maxillary, ethmoidal and sphenoidal air sinuses, deviated nasal septum, pneumatized middle turbinate, that is concha bullosa, ethmoidal air cell, that is Haller cell, and paradoxical middle turbinate. So the first image is axial CT bone window, which demonstrates concha bullosa in right middle turbinate and nasal septum deviation towards the left side. The second image is coronal CT bone window, which demonstrates paradoxical left middle turbinate. The third image is the coronal CT bone window, which shows Haller cell on the left side. In this slide, the first image shows marked mucosal thickening of bilateral maxillary sinuses and inferior turbinate hypertrophy. The second image is a case of frontal sinusitis, and the third image is a case of sphenoidal sinusitis. So among the 50 patients who underwent CT, the most common type of sinus involvement was maxillary sinus, which comprised of almost 64%, followed by frontal, ethmoidal sinus, and sphenoidal sinus. Anatomical variants observed in these patients were deviated nasal septum, was present in almost 36% of cases, concha bullosa in 30%, followed by inferior turbinate hypertrophy in 14%, Haller cell in 4%, and paradoxical middle turbinate in 2%. Notably, the presence of deviated nasal septum showed a relatively higher association with sinus involvement, occurring in 36% of sinus cases. Concha bullosa, another anatomical variant, was found in 30% of sinus patients, further suggesting a potential relationship with sinusitis. So, concluding my study, deviated nasal septum is a prevalent factor in chronic sinusitis patients, potentially contributing to disruption in normal mucociliary clearance of the paranasal sinuses. Anatomical variation such as Haller cell, although incidentally found in sinusitis patient, lack a strong correlation to the condition. Understanding this anatomical variation can guide surgeons in performing functional endoscopic sinus surgeries by providing crucial information about patient-specific factors. Thank you.